sometimes people say, just last weekend in Philadelphia, someone asked this question. What if I have unconscious beliefs that are in my way? And we say, well, if you're not feeling any emotion about them, then they're not a big enough player to be affecting you. And if they are a big enough player to be affecting you, then you're going to be feeling emotion around them. So isn't it nice when you realize that you have emotion that's pointing at something that's in your way? So we want, just for a moment, because this has been intense and a little bit heavy, we want you to understand how really beautifully and easily this all works. We want you to realize that your inner being does know everything that you want and where you are in relationship to it. And this is the most important thing that you'll hear from us all day. Your inner being knows what the path of least resistance is between where you are and where you want to be. Say it again. Your inner being knows where your path of least resistance is. Your inner being understands your path, and your inner being understands the resistance that you've put on the trail. Your inner being is not upset about the resistance that you've put on the trail. Your inner being is aware of the resistance that you've put on the trail, but your inner being is navigating you around the resistance that you've put on the trail. Because your inner being knows you don't have to go back and clean up that resistance. You just can't look at it without it being a blockade that will not let you move along your trail. Does that make sense to you? You don't have to go back and clean things up. You just have to get tuned into your inner being, who will guide you through the path of least resistance to what you want. Your inner being never says to you, gotta go back and clean that up. You've gotta go back to the time that you were 10, and you've gotta confront those demons, and you've gotta bring them out into the open, and you've got to find a new place. No, 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 no. That's not what your inner being is saying, and that's not what we're saying to you, and that's not what we wanted to happen to you. But if there's resistance on your trail that you keep tripping over, then you either got to get rid of the resistance or, and this is the better option, you got to get rid of the resistance. First of all, friends, you can't. So give that up. You got to do one of two things. You got to give up the resistance. You can't do that. You can't undo that. You can't stop remembering things. You can't not see a photograph and not remember what it meant, or hear music and remember what it meant. In other words, you're not going to undo that resistance. All right? You're not going to undo that resistance. You're not going to have not lived what you've lived. How about that? You're not going to unlive what you've lived, nor would you want to, because you put the other end of it in your vortex, which is calling you. You put the do want in your vortex, which is calling you. So your vortex, your inner being, are calling you toward what you are wanting. And even though all that resistance is peppered all around on your trail, your inner being says, come this way, come this way, come this way. Meet this person, see this, see this, see this. Your inner being never says, get rid of it. Your inner being says, ignore it. Your inner being says, come this way. Come this way, 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 come this way. And you say, but what about this that I did? Or what about this that I said? What about this that I thought? That's resistance that your inner being is not asking you to focus upon and make more. Your inner being is saying, come this way, come this way, come this way. Can you feel how many things that we have accomplished today in terms of an understanding of what's going on with this business of creating your own reality? And the most significant thing here, and it is hugely significant, is that when you know what you don't want, you know what you do want. And your inner being is always calling you there. And when you feel anger, it's because you're not going the way your inner being would have you go. You're stopping to examine the resistance. Ooh, I think I need to talk about this. Your inner being says, we're not talking about it, but I think I need to talk about it. I think I need to repent about it, or I think I need to ask forgiveness about it, or I think I need to unlive it in some way. And your inner being is saying, take your attention away from it, and it will no longer exist as a vibrational factor in your experience. You say, yeah, but it was big. And your inner being says, doesn't matter how big it is, take your attention away from it, and it will no longer exist as a vibrational factor in your point of attraction. You say, yeah, but it was really, really big. Your inner being says, it doesn't matter how big it is, take your attention away from it, and it will no longer exist. There's no law of exclusion, and there's no law of redemption, and there's no law of repentance, and there's no law of unliving, and there's no law of undoing. There is only the law of attraction, which is responding to who you are. And this is the thing that we want so much for you to understand: who you are. That's what you said. Who am I? Who am I? You're a source energy being in a physical time-space reality with a vibrational part of you that is so huge and calling you. That's who you are. You are liquid love, and when you are not loving, then you're off of who you are. You are happy, and when you're not happy, then you're off of who you are. You're easy, and when you're not easy, you're off of who you are. You can tell by the way you feel. Warmer, 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 colder, colder, colder. That's all it is. We make much, 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 much. We blame you. No. We make much too much of all of this because you care so much about understanding why things haven't gone better that you don't just let go and let them be better. That's why. Really good conversation.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So let's recap just a little bit, because we want to, together, find that vibrational place that fits right with where you now are, because these are the ingredients that have accomplished this leading edge conversation, and we are appreciating a lot you being here. Not because you dragged yourself here, not because you thought you should be here, and not because somebody else dragged you here. We appreciate you being here because law of attraction brought you here. Your vibrational offering is the reason that you were an important component of this conversation. And there is no one in the room that was not an important part of this conversation. There are so many people that you are interacting with out in what you call your world, who are not deliberate about their creation. They are what we call creating by default. And by that we mean they are observing through their physical senses situations, and then they are having knee-jerk reactions to those situations. And sometimes, in fact, often, in fact, about more than 80% of the time, they're more than 90% of the time, about 95% of the time, their knee-jerk reactions are negative reactions. And what that means is they're observing and reacting in a way that cannot turn the tide on what they are observing. But here you are, what by Earth population standards would seem to be a small cluster of consciousness. Here you are, contemplating from your broader perspective. Here you are realizing, maybe for the first time, the benefit of what all of that contrast provides for you. And here you are, like everybody else on the planet, creating a vortex, only you understand that your vortex exists. So you have an option that most people don't have. You have an option of looking forward to the unfolding of what you've put there, rather than being beat up by the reality that currently exists. Everyone on the planet stands on a platform that is really wonderful, in that you have stability beyond your ability to even realize it. So much about your environment, you don't have to worry about at all. And in that unnecessary or absence of worrying about the unnecessary things, you get to be on this leading edge where you get to create in the new environment, in the new way. Understanding vibration and understanding law of attraction gives you a skill set that only a small part of your civilization has stumbled on before. Just understanding that you are an extension of source energy, and that the larger part of you still exists, gives you an advantage because you now understand that that larger part of you is active with you here today, which, if you will think about what we've talked about here today, means, or will give you a reason to understand how your guidance system works, what negative or positive emotion means. So you have, let's say, a vibrational advantage. You have the advantage of knowing that with a little bit of focus, that you can accomplish something energetically that will give you a leverage that will carry you far further than the majority of the population who is depending upon action to make things happen for themselves. So if you'll leave this gathering with this word in your mind, leverage, we're speaking for you, I am going to experience the leverage, the advantage, the power, utilizing the energy that creates worlds. I am going to do the energy work first, and then I'm going to follow my joyful impulse to the action that will demonstrate what I've created vibrationally and energetically. We're speaking for you still. I am no longer going to rely upon my action to fix things, to make things. My action will from this point forward be the way in which I enjoy the things that I've created through doing the energy work. My emotions mean everything to me because my emotion is my indicator of my alignment with my power or not, my alignment with that leverage or not. When you move forward with negative emotion, you're out there on the raw and ragged edge on your own without any of the resources or any of the infinite intelligence or any of the advantages that you receive when you are in alignment. You just cannot get there from there. So as you watch the majority of the world scrambling around, squabbling over resources, worried about things through their action, but you step back a little bit from it and feel the power of clarity that meditation will bring you, the power of the energy that creates worlds that happiness will bring you. As you cater, and we're really using that word specifically, as you cater for just a little while to the emotions that feel good to you, you will practice a vibration that allows this energy that creates worlds to flow through you. And then what you're going to witness is an avalanche of thoughts turning to things in your experience, the likes of which you have not experienced before. You're going to discover the pent-up energy that you have not been allowing because you've been focused upon things that have been pinching it off. So words like opening your valve or getting into the vortex or getting into the receiving mode, these are the words that are going to be of most importance to you in terms of what we teach. But the way you get there is, I'm feeling really happy today. Today is a really good day. I'm really looking forward to this. I really like that, or I really like that, or I really like that, or I really appreciate that, or I'm thankful for that. These are the key words and observations that will lead you consistently and profoundly to your power. We know about your power because we're standing in your vortex with all of it. We know about your potential because we've seen it all clearly. We know that you're the creator of your own reality because you always have been. We know about what's coming for you because we have witnessed the shifting in your vibration in these hours that we've been together. We know about the ease that is coming next because we know about the logic that you will discover in the morning after you've had a good night's sleep. So leave this gathering and don't worry about homework and don't talk to anyone about it because they won't understand it anyway. Just leave with the improvement in your vibration and then witness what the improvement in your vibration will net you, will yield to you. And then just make a decision to live happily ever after. There isn't anything that anyone wants, whether it's a material object or a relationship or a pile of money or a circumstance or an event. There isn't anything that anyone wants that is for any other reason than they believe they would feel better in the having of it. What we want to have convinced you of here today, and what we've felt movement of, joyful movement in your vibration about, is that you do not have to have an experience in order to shift emotion. And if you will believe us and be willing to shift your emotion without the manifestation that justifies the shift, then you will be this powerful creator with all of this leverage. But if you need a manifestation to respond to. If you're going to continue to be a knee-jerk responder to conditions, then you'll have no control. If you will shift your emotion without justification in form of manifestation, then the manifestations must follow. It is that simple.